Good, how are you?
Alright, here we go.
Yeah,
here we go. Alright, here we go. So, productivity right now, open staff 93 an hour. Sales up 11.3. And it's, this week, averaging 92 units going out the door a day.
What's a unit?
Unit is a thing we make.
So, these units are this big?
Yep. So, yeah, it could be a showcase. It could be, it's an average.
And that's this week's average?
Yes, it is. So our typical average is between 60 and 70 right now.
So we want a 6-week trailing report, and then we want to combine three of those units to equate to a unit, maybe. But do the math on the time, because we're trying to get a metric, you guys, that means something, and units are going to be stretched out over a long period of time because there's such wild variation. So these things are a real high number, which is cool. Mostly we're kicking butt with the dollars. So it's a relation between labor, but we want to come up with something that kind of makes sense. But it's going to be a long tail because there's such a wide variety of what we call units, which is what Cosell does over there too.
What I like is that we all feel the 92 units going out a day, whether it's small or large.
Right, it's a thing you handle.
Right.
Yeah, that's a good point. Is you're handling a thing. Yeah.
How's it feel there, Jeremy, after 92 units?
It feels a lot better today.
Yeah. So the sales and the 93 an hour are the productivity is the 4-week.
Yeah. Amy, did you tape this up?
Did.
So okay. See what's going on, you guys? We started measuring here. See? Thank you. We all depend on that.
Okay, moving forward. It's a good video. We haven't watched one in a while, but it's good to see what our customers see with these two guys. And of course it's Lagerding.
Handsome guys, oh my gosh. Indeed.
Yeah. Yeah.
Cool.
How about that? So, here we go. I'm just going to watch this thing. You know why that happened?
What's up, Sir? Trevor here. That's Mike.
Hello.
We're down here at Zombie Design. And we've finished up your lovely dove gray pedestal. Did a fantastic job. Mike's going to give us some measurements.
Fine job on it, Trevor. Yeah. Turned out great.
Beautiful.
It was a collaborative effort, actually.
Yeah.
11 and a half.
Alrighty.
11 and a half.
Perfect.
30 inches tall.
Awesome. And sir, we got paperwork. That's exactly what you ordered in.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, awesome. We're going to send this out today via FedEx. It's going to go to your 83rd Street partner.
Let's pan over to the handsome man.
Say hi, Mark.
That's handsome Mark.
Thank you, Stuart.
So when you get it, do a lovely little talk here. You're going to put something. Why don't you send us a video, picture. Mike would love to see it.
Yeah, we would. Yeah.
Do it. Do it. But they're going to send me over there to take the picture.
Other than that, Stuart, man, thanks so much for your business. And you have yourself a fantastic day.
Thanks, Stuart.
It's a 1-minute video too, guys. It's a 1-minute video. So.
Yeah.
That's a keeper.
That is a keeper.
Can I have the link to that one?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you. Keep it in its virginal state.
Yeah. So this is a great video. I'm not gonna read the whole thing here, but it's a really heartfelt, amazing letter.
Can you
recap this for?
Oh my gosh. This lady's nephew has autism, and he's like very creative. He's 15 years old. She sent me a picture of him, his sister, and his mom. Or I guess her sister. Anyway. And I'm reading this, I'm like crying. And then I reply back, I'm like, if there are typos, I can't, you know, anyway. a very special statue, and she just, very heartfelt. She's doing this, I think, all from the stone, probably hard to type on. But so then she writes back and shares that my message back to her last night. She's crying, I'm like, okay, enough with the tears. So I'm writing back and tears are coming down my eyes. So guys, we touch so many people and we don't know. I mean, you know, we do a lot of trade shows, but a lot of individuals. And I'm just so grateful for people like this. This is one of the many reasons I love, and I put, love my job. This is a big deal. You guys are a big deal. So anyway, very touching, very creative young man, and special letter for Mitchell is the young boy's name. So Statue of St. Michael, as it was being blessed by a certain father. Yeah, Father Manuel Sousa. Anyway.
I'll leave it up here for free on Friday. People can
crazy
read it.
Crazy awesome.
It's a little long to read out loud, but...
crazy awesome.
Yeah, it's very cool. So.
Thanks, Wendy.
Thank you, guys.
Did you charge some extra for the crying email?
Oh, my gosh. Yeah. Okay. I mean, it just... Yeah.
Okay.
You didn't
shooting.
Short on anything.
I know, but I mean, seriously. It was close.
All right. Greg Young, John Bathamu next week.
Who's doing it today?
Steven.
I am.
The toothbrush was used last week. Who used the toothbrush last for the edges?
I haven't used it this week.
Okay.
It's weird. I just brushed my teeth in there this morning.
But you didn't use toothpaste.
Yeah.
With whitening like that.
It's next, just a little bleach.
So thank you, just so you know. All right, the electrical escape from today, corner light is being fixed.
Yeah, that was mine from Mark Zaymor.
Oh,
and when he calls for me to install them, I can say I've just done 4 on my own pedestals in the office.
Perfect.
So now I can walk him through it. It's like, it's just so easy. Thanks to Aaron. Thank you.
Very good. Thank you. And seems like we got a couple weird electrical things going on recently.
Yeah.
So we'll
yeah.
be on that. The red zone. Main saw's back out of the red. Okay, so that can go away. Paint booth still cooking. How we doing over there, guys?
Doing good.
Doing good? We're gonna hit our mark today for the painting?
Absolutely.
Dan?
We're out of the red for today.
Okay.
Next week's kind of heavy, so on top of it.
Okay. Who can come work tomorrow? 8 o'clock start.
I'll be here for the morning.
Ben?
How late are people staying?
That's usually about 8 to noon to just knock things out for the week. Can't make it. Anybody else? Jeffy?
I'll be here.
Just you and me?
Yeah.
Okay, me and Jeffy.
I can swing it on Sunday too this weekend if you need to, so.
The paint booth, you're going to be good for Monday because there's quite a big stack.
Yeah, I'll be here Sunday.
Okay, so, you hear something?
For me, and I'll do whatever tomorrow to get that ahead of for you too. I can do paint booth stuff tomorrow, so.
Okay, thank you. Anybody else?
Yeah.
You will too?
Mm-hmm.
Perfect, thank you. Dead focus, two reds. Bummer. Make sure we go into that. We're going to start focusing a lot more on this actually coming up. Pardon?
Walk of shame.
Walk of shame. Walk. Who's going to do the walk of shame? Okay.
School did just get
back.
No,
it's
just Mike.
On that one side. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we got a lot on our side.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, the pain. Very good. So yesterday, we quickly hit a bunch of stuff actually in 10 minutes. It was pretty great. We were able to laugh quite a bit with Louis C.K. and everyone's amazing right now. No One's Happy video. That's just such a great piece of work that he did. Looking back to 2012 pictures that I took, including saddle tables. And here's our modern inculcation of saddle tables. You see how far we've come? That was a stack of about 12 that I was doing at the time.
Much better.
The plywood substructure. And we touched on some one-piece flow with Aaron cutting and gluing his own parts for his custom pieces and keeping it out of the main flow, which is really neat. And it helped the lack of downtime over there. And we also had a great August Walnut Riser Hansei session with some good takeaways that hopefully we can bring into this new run that we're doing. And I think we have some good direction going on there. Am I missing something? Jeremiah.
I already started with August. It's much, much lighter.
Okay.
Boxing, numbering, just the whole flow of everything.
So your body feels different.
Yeah.
Good.
Big guy.
Very well. Am I just forgetting something from yesterday?
Yeah, those two things that came out of that Hansei too was that Ben, his new nickname is CNC.
Okay.
That's what Brad calls him, the CNC.
It's gonna be hard on cross training.
Yeah. Okay, anything else from yesterday?
We got two more bends. 2P walks around carrying light things.
Yes,
small things.
Small things, that's right. 2P carries small things. Okay. Very well. Here's a video from this is Philippe and Jake.
Hey guys. I'm here in the Rocky Mountains with my friend Jake from Zalem Design, and we were discussing like go and watch, go and stop and watch, and I was telling Jake, you know Jake, I tried to do it, but I'm very uncomfortable with the idea of standing still for 3 hours just watching a process.
Yeah, time's valuable.
Time is valuable, and I'm really not comfortable with that.
Yeah.
Because I have so many things to do and it's painful, but it's so useful at the same time.
Uh-huh.
So I discussing here with Jake, he told me the most unbelievable thing they are doing to improve that process. So how are you doing that?
So what we did was we took a camera, we set it up on the top, and we had a camera film different work cells for a whole day, whole 8-hour day. And then we could take that video and speed it up and shrink an 8-hour day into 25 minutes.
Okay, so instead of staying there for 8 hours, you just watch for 30 minutes the whole day. So.
Yep. And then what we did was we took everybody who was being filmed and we brought them up, and it's not about shaming, it's just
What do they think about that? So how do they, having a camera filming them?
Yeah, you know, it's It was not a popular decision. People felt they were being watched, and but that's not what it's about. It's just an exercise.
And you did it yourself.
Yes. So we did these videos, and I went up and watched mine where, it was painful, absolutely painful. I wanted to turn it off. I wanted to cry. But that perspective you can't gain. Like if you put a camera on, have it follow you around and watch what you do all day, it totally changes how you look at what everything you do.
It's really a helicopter view at work.
Bird's eye view.
So this is I will do it when I get back to Portugal. Yeah. I'm here for the Lean Summit 2016. I have to thank Zylan Design and Ashley from Climb Easy for this great event. I'm learning so much this week.
And
oh shit! What was that one last thing? Yeah. And then the bear took him out.
Yeah. I'll probably volunteer to go to Portugal in 2 weeks. So.
Yeah, me too. I'm also
I'll take a passport.
Take a number.
If Greg says you can, remember that.
Greg, I'll take a trip.
Okay. So things from today.
My wife and me. That's fine. Forward.
Dem things.
Focus board.
Focus board. What about it?
Get on it.
Get on it.
Stay on it.
Most importantly, make sure that it's representing a really important improvement that's making us more productive, making our lives better. What else is today?
Customers are touched.
Yes.
Big time. What we do.
Big time. Every day.
We got an update too when you're done.
Well, Philippe's talk, but that kind of watching that video too kind of goes like thinking back to when the summit came through too. Like all those guys came through and they were in all like stuff that we do that they don't do. So it'd be interesting to see, you know, what they do that we don't do.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That's the whole point.
Little things like videos or this or that. They're like, wow, you do that, and we're like, oh. So it kind of brings my brother's brain to think, what do they do that we don't do differently? You know?
Yeah. See what?
10 minutes is up.
See it a different way. See what I see.
Yeah.
You know, if you see it, is it? I mean, I don't can anybody here because, you know, the only thing that would piss me off is someone doesn't share information or is just a jerk. But if you're going to make mistakes, as we have regularly scheduled them, I think, it's like, just see the things that are going on. If we're going to learn, right, and we're going to try to, you know, get to this level of excellence, right, it's going to be through actually observing what is going on. That's just the truth. And that's what I see. It's like the same thing. It's like this is it's the helicopter cam, the Greg cam, the lean cam, the learn cam. And I said to a couple of people, this is a thing that I don't think we could have rolled out without building the foundation of respect here first. And no matter what way you slice it, it's still sort of, oh, come on. It's like, okay, I'm going to leave the room. You go ahead and just be with yourself and look at that. That's really the best thing that I can possibly do, is not necessarily physically hover over your shoulder, but be detached from that. So nobody got fired for eating too many snacks at the table saw, did they? Right? Did I need to tell you? No, okay. Are you adding value? No, well, you're adding calories maybe. But so a couple positive indicators. You can see this. I just met with Craig, and this is really, really cool. So thank you. And you know, thanks to Seth and the office team and the people in 4LJ, everybody who's been doing this and learning. This whole level has come up, and I'm so grateful. We're doing this, in the middle of putting that summit together, so it's huge, and I'm psyched. Mm-hmm. Thank you. So we're actually doing what I've been told to do for, you know, 20 years, which is make visual indicators that tell us what is going on. So Seth's going to put some more lead indicators related to sales and what's trending there, so we'll have a similar thing between their outgoing activities. So that's fantastic. Other thing is I'm investing in equipment. I just purchased an edge bander, SCMI in Atlanta. So that's gonna be here in probably 3 weeks, 2 to 3 weeks. So we're gonna make some room for that. That was a learning curve. I spoke at a lean breakout session with Brad. He invited me in. I thought I was gonna go shopping for stuff, and I burned up all of the day before yesterday getting that prepped, and we pulled it off. It wasn't my best work, but I had people come to me after that event. I shared our story, my version of the story, and between Brad, me watching Brad, and having a couple people come to me and say, I like what you're doing, thank you, it made it worth it. That's all that matters. We saved one soul, and I think we did. So Brad's got more consulting work going on, quite frankly. And then I'm going to talk to you about creating true one-piece flow and understanding what that means. and my goal is to get our turnaround down to 3 days by the beginning of the year. And the way we can do that is to really create flow, actual flow, not batch work. And Brad's more than willing to come out and just spend a couple of days here sharing what he's learned at his tender age on that process. So a lot of things going on. And then an air compressor, a screw compressor out there that's going to give us nice, fresh, clean air for the booth. And top it off, we're going to sanding sealer and regular top coat. That drives the cost down of the sanding sealer. We're going to have a manifold. We switch it between that on a clear. So you're in the booth and you can just go ahead and lay this down. It'll sand easier, lower the burden, less waste of sandpaper. So pretty psyched about all these improvements physically to the environment. So it's because of our ability to do this that I can go ahead and pour some cash into the development of the facility. So
awesome.
Thanks to everybody. Yeah, and I wish I could spend, I should have spent at least another day there. It's just, I ran into Steve Schwartz, I ran into John Murphy, who helped us with the CNC. He was down there, ran into other people down there. It was pretty cool. Incredible show.
Awesome. And do you get any insights about, since we service the trade show industry, any things that we're missing that we might have thought about, like, well, you know, if you're at a trade show, we service the trade show industry, what are we missing? What are things are...
The truth is, I was so incredibly myopic about learning everything I needed to know about all edge banners and sprinting around this million square foot facility, learning, going back. I didn't really, other than taking some pictures of some cool fixtures. So the truth is, no, other than some cool stuff you can do with CNCs to make trade show booths. And I think narrowing down our customer target has been critical, and I had a discussion with Seth this morning about that, and we got total clarity as to who we're going after now. So. Mm-hmm.
Good. Awesome.
Yeah, and I'm going to be out of here Monday, Tuesday, maybe Wednesday with my beloved up in the mountains, checking out some new towns.
Cool.
So
switch it back for me.
Yeah. So I got it. Yeah. Thank you, Aaron.
I shout out Tony and Greg and anybody else who helped with the quality in the booth. Thanks for that. It's the stuff coming out of there is great. So the struggle associated with the heartbreak of being fish-eyed and stuff like that is mm-hmm. bad. So yeah. Thanks for spending the time making it sweet. Appreciate it.
I do as well.
Yeah. Also, by the way, that edge banner, it's the shit. It's got a leading edge joiner.
I thought you were going to hire Tony because he's an
edge banding
machine.
Oh, he is. We're going to put this machine to use elsewhere. Here,
yeah,
what
yeah.
We need.
I like it.
Basically, everything's a tool. Thanks.
No shout out for Aaron. Keeping me from blowing my head off.
Yeah. Thanks for keeping your guns locked up.
Yeah.
I also have gratitude for Woody for this job here. The one piece blow, something that would have been added to my plate with all the Uggs drops, so it reduced some burden for me. So it was neat to see that, and it's cool to see it in action.
I got one for Ben. He's just doing awesome on that CNC. Mm. He's been really busy, but he's just doing it. Thank you.
Yeah.
I'll ride his coattails.
Yeah.
Thanks for not blowing your head off.
That's awesome.
Anything else?
I have one already in there, but it's what I said earlier. Aaron walked me through changing the corner light on the one, and I did all the four. So thank you for taking time always and helping me. Appreciate it.
Is it freeloader today?
Yes.
Okay. Go ahead.
Jeff, thanks for knowledge sharing. Edge knowledge. I'm aspiring to be edgelicious.
I had to shout it back because this week I've been riding in and working in the thing that I was going to take a picture of to show you guys because the edges got down to, they're like half the size now, they're perfect.
That's cool. That's called a kumbaya.
Thank you.
That's one card, two names.
Yeah.
Back at you. 50% value on the coupon. Are we going to draw the coupon or not?
Is it? Oh, it is
it's that day.
Yeah. It is.
Throw them in and pull them out.
All right.
Any
in.
More love or not? Can we
one more thing.
Accumulated.
With this. Yeah. It's no air. Bryce working at the compressor. It's going to be probably maybe half an hour, 4 or 5 minutes.
Well, heads up, we need to be more diligent on the dust collection because it's getting way too full and they can't dump it all. It's causing problems for us, so we need to be checking it, writing down when it's going out and getting full.
How's that sea solution coming on, Tony?
It's great.
Well, everything is changing because now all the CNC stuff goes direct to the dust bin outside. Before it was going to the dumpster, now it goes straight, right?
Yeah.
So that's changing. That we need to change. We need to remember that you have to call and see.
Well, just when it's
Murray's.
When it's full, it's full though. So we got to figure that one out.
Yeah, this is.
Can we just get a second dumpster?
Like,
what he's
saying is it's filling up faster, so
yeah,
we need to.
Yeah, I hear that. Yeah. So we've been good at under 10 minutes all week. We're at about 22 minutes right now. Is that correct? How about
2011.
20. Okay. So let's figure out the end of the meeting here. Any more shout-outs?
Jake gets a gift card for teaching Rob.
What did he teach him?
I don't know. Doesn't say. Just says for teaching.
We don't have time to write the whole details of everything.
Okay, so teaching, that's great. That's what we do. Teach and train.
Yeah. Okay. Sharing knowledge. Okay.
Jake, slap it back on the jar.
Okay.
That's what it is.
So Jake, look for Amy after the meeting.
Yeah.
Yeah, good luck with that.
And that's it. Thank you.